Stay tuned for the biggest fish, the hottest bites, this week here on In-Depth Outdoors. With James Holst.
Look at that. Wow, is that an incredible fish.
And the rest of the IDO fishing team. We're headed to the best fisheries across the upper Midwest and Canada. We'll fish longer, explore unfished bodies of water, and go further off the beaten path in search of the hottest bites in fresh water. With Pat McSherry.
All right, what a fish.
Andy Fioca.
Wow.
Get the colors on this fish.
And Mike Anselmo.
Man, he's bumping.
This is In-Depth Outdoors.
Thanks for tuning in, everybody, to another episode of In-Depth Outdoors. My name is James Holst, and on today's show, Mother Nature has called an audible. Canceled winter temporarily. A couple things have happened here that do not normally happen in January. Incredibly warm temperatures for a very long period of time, and a lot of rain. Basically, during the days we had allocated to film this week's show, it was either kind of a misty fog nonstop, or an actual downpour. So Mother Nature calls an audible, we adjust as well. This week we head to Lake Michigan, where we're gonna fish with Chris Brown. Now, Chris is an angler that I've been talking with online for the better part of a year. Chris loves catching big lake trout, so do I. So we've been sharing tips, stories, fish photos over the course of the last year, and once things kinda lined up here with this warmer weather this last week, Chris sent me an invite to come on down with the boat, catch some lake trout on some walleye rods. So that's what today's show is all about. Mother Nature calls an audible, anglers adjust. So we're headed for Lake Michigan, where we're gonna catch some fantastic lake trout. Steelhead, brown trout are also an option. So stick around, I think you're gonna enjoy today's show. So today we're getting the chance to take advantage of a very rare late January warm-up, and it's all across the upper Midwest. Everything just started to thaw, and kind of had an itch all of a sudden to get out in the boat, do some open water fishing, and behind me we've got Chris Brown from Indiana. Yeah, I've never been to Indiana before either, and we're down here on Lake Michigan, Indiana waters, to fish lake trout. Now, I've been in touch with Chris Brown here for almost a year, isn't it?
We've
been
kind of just chatting back and forth. Yeah, a little bit over a year. Yeah.
Guy catches big fish. I like big fish pictures, and we just started chatting back and forth about the big lakers that I catch up on Lake Superior, and see, you caught me talking and he's catching. So he'll do a much better job explaining in the next few minutes about what we're here doing than I ever could. So Chris, I'm not even fighting the fish, and I'm just happy as a guy could get right now.
They are certainly a fun fish.
A day and a half ago, standing on ice. Got back from that shoot, dropped the footage off, grabbed the boat, and ran right over here to Indiana to fish with Chris Brown. Oh, blondie.
Yeah, they really lose their color after the fall.
There you be. And I might be fishing a blade bait here real quick. That's a nice first fish.
Yes, sir. Good about average size for here in Indiana. So.
That's the average.
Yeah. This time of year, you know, jigging, you'll get the bigger fish.
Sure.
Than, you know, summertime, so. See if we can put it all together. You can see that he's...
That fish is not done with you yet.
No, he's full of life. That's for sure.
Those are good hooks.
Not a bad little fish to start off the morning here.
And you get a lot of fish, what, 15, 20 pounds?
Yeah, you know, we'll see them in that class. 20 is a little bit rare, but, you know, we see them here in springtime.
Nice.
Certainly, so we'll try and put some bigger quality fish in the boat.
That kind of beat up nose, is that from digging around on the rocks, catching those gobies?
Yeah, absolutely. He's chasing down there.
Got to earn your
lunch.
His
dinner, yep. So he's beat up. You'll see a lot of that.
Good work, Chris.
All right, let's get back at it. Let's get him back in the water.
Mission accomplished, man. Way to start it out.
Yeah.
Good work.
Let's get back at it.
Yeah, those Lakers love this time of year. That water's just a little bit above freezing. They still fight real good, though. How are you working that bait?
Yeah, so I'm just really lifting it up, maybe giving it a few twitches at the top of that pole, and then letting it fall back down. And a lot of times, it'll hit it on that fall, you know, and pin it against that bottom.
Fish.
There you go.
Yeah, you're right. I didn't feel that fish ping it.
No.
Just come up. I'm sure he pinned it to the ground. That's how they get those smashed up little noses.
Yes, sir. They're just a blast, you know, this time of year on light gear like this.
Every time of year, but yes, yeah. this is the best way to handle this fish. You know, I think you kind of put it in the best terms. They're not a horizontal fighter, they're a vertical. They're up and down.
Yeah, absolutely.
They're not going to make that 100 yard away from the boat run.
No, they're not. But they will want to get back to the bottom.
Yep.
Every time.
These guys are one of my favorite fish.
Absolutely.
Oh, I'm giving them the beans. Thank you. Oh, come here, Blondie. Oh,
nice
I don't
fish.
See that bait anywhere, so I'm probably gonna need a pliers.
Let me grab those for you, sir. You got the net?
I do, thank you. Such a unique coloration on this fish.
There you go, James.
I'm gonna grab that net just so it doesn't flop.
Yeah.
Not hooked anywhere terrible by any means. There we go. All right. You know what? I'm not used to that coloration. I love the fish still.
Yeah.
He doesn't fight any different.
No, he does not.
So that's about the average size.
Yeah, that's what we'll get. We'll hopefully tie into some bigger ones today.
That is a plenty respectable fish. And on spinning gear, they fight just like freight trains.
Absolutely.
I love them.
Absolutely.
All right, that girl's gotta go back. I love my ice fishing, but this is a wonderful way to take a break from it. Off she goes. That's cool. If I get to do that a dozen times a day, I'm gonna be a happy guy.
Yeah, well, let's put it together.
I love me a lake trout.
Skeeter Boat Center is now a full-service Warrior Boats dealer, offering the complete line of Warrior Boats, all covered by reliable Yamaha outboards. With dealerships located in Ramsey, Minnesota and Chippewa Falls, Wisconsin, Skeeter Boat Center carries more Warrior Boat models in stock than any other Warrior Boat dealer. No matter which Warrior model is right for you, you'll receive the same attention to detail and service after the sale that made Skeeter Boat Center the number one Skeeter dealer by volume in the Midwest. For the best selection of fiberglass fishing boats and unmatched service, stop in or visit us online at SkeeterBoatCenter.com.
From the first time you pick up a tuned-up custom rod, you'll know you're holding something special. A rod not mass-produced, but built one at a time by the hands of gifted craftsmen. Rods like the Precision, ice fishing's most versatile multi-species rod, or the Precision Noodle, with a tip so sensitive you'll never fish a spring bobber again. And the Commander, the rod that's never met a big fish it couldn't best. Tuned Up Custom Rods. Ice rods handcrafted for you and the way you fish.
This winter, set a trap for your next trophy with iFish Pro. Ideal for all species, iFish Pro is an innovative fishing system that allows an angler to use their favorite rod and reel instead of trying to manage the fish hand over hand.
Oh, there's a fly right there.
Complete your ice fishing arsenal with iFish Pro, tactical ice gear that puts the fight back into tip-up fishing. Find iFish Pro online at iFishPro.com or at your favorite sporting goods retailer.
Oh yeah. Good work.
Just a ball.
Buddy, I can see why you like this and then some.
Yes, sir.
So when does this fishing start each year?
Well, you know, usually we got the spawn in the fall. And, you know, that's pretty tough fishing when they're just worried about doing their thing. And then after our first couple freezes, you know, and they're done with their spawn, it's pretty much game on. You know, it's such a hit and miss fishery.
Yeah.
We get ice flows that come in and, you know, the water clarity has to be good. It can get murked up here.
Well, and being on the South Shore, I'm sure north winds are death to any prospect of getting on the water. You let me know when you're getting close. I'll come on down.
I'm getting close here.
I'm coming. We're doing a really nice job of taking turns here. I like this. Polite.
Absolutely.
Come here, fish.
And there he is. In the boat.
And I got a pliers waiting for you.
All right. Yes,
is.
It's not a proper plier, it's a Hemos, but it should do. So on an average day, how many fish do you catch like that?
You know, we have our better days where we're upwards of 20 fish, you know? But every day is a little bit different. Look at those nostrils on that.
I don't care what color they are or where we catch them, they are cool, cool fish.
Absolutely. Well, let's get this one back in and get another one, huh?
I can honestly say I've never put Indiana and lake trout together before, but that just changed.
I think we're about the farthest south you can get to catch these fish.
I would imagine.
So we'll get them back. Beautiful fish, though. Back to the bottom she goes.
Nice work, man.
Let's do it again.
You're showing me a good time. There's a nice fish coming out of the boat. That's a thick mark, man. If only you could look at the fish finder and know how big he actually was.
90 pounds.
I don't know if I want that technology.
Oh! Oh, my word! That was a lifted up, tight line crush right at the side of the boat.
Awesome.
I have no idea what I'm tied into here. Wow, that was an angry, angry fish. You know, so many of these fish that we've caught have basically taken the bait as it was coming down to the bottom to pin it. This one kind of had it top of the lift, tight line, so I could really feel that collision. I mean, these are really nice average size fish.
Yeah.
Indiana lake trout. Like I said.
Even saying it sounds funny.
Ah, in the best possible way, man. This is good stuff. We've got lake trout in Minnesota, but no place you're gonna try to fish them out of a boat. Could do Lake Superior maybe, but that's not a very friendly lake in January. This is a fat one.
Yeah?
Yes.
Put the feed bag on.
This is a wide girl. Oh. Come on, this one has not missed many meals.
And another one in the net.
Very cool.
There you go.
Thank you, fish. Thank you, Chris. Come here, get a hold of that tail. Settle down. There we go. Out. Got a little line wrapped around her. Wiggle her out of there. There we go. Look at that chubbo. Woohoo! I get bonus points for the catch on that one. Come here, you. Oh, what a great fish. Easily one of my favorite fish in freshwater. They got attitude, they got stamina, they got pulling power. I mean, that's gotta be a 10-pound fish or six.
Somewhere around there.
Yeah.
Definitely put on the...
At some point, who cares?
Yeah.
Right?
They fight, so counts in my book.
Yeah. Back you go, fishy. We're catching a fish now about every 5-10 minutes, which lake trout fishing, that's a pretty good clip. Now on the gear side of things, we're fishing the Okuma Helio spinning rods. All the rods are 7'1" long, mediums, medium heavies. The same line on all the reels, that's a 4-pound diameter, 10-pound test, braided line, Suffex 832, and we've got about a 10-foot section of 15-pound fluorocarbon leader. That fluorocarbon leader gets chewed up through the course of the day. I've actually lost a couple of baits. Those zebra mussels are so sharp. And what that long leader allows you to do is cut off a little chunk, retie, and not have to replace the whole leader. So pretty simple setup. Basically, it's walleye gear, some blade baits, and some great weather with a cool dude, and we're out here just pounding on some great fish. I'm having fun, Chris.
Absolutely.
I'm starting to look like I've been involved in a pretty good day of Laker fishing.
Markham's new pocket-sized handheld underwater cameras, the Recon 5 and 5 Plus, use a 5-inch color display to deliver superior screen detail and employ a combination of dark water LED and infrared lighting to punch through the darkness. The Recon 5 Plus adds a built-in DVR and on-screen display for critical information, previously only available on full-sized underwater viewing systems. This winter, see what you've been missing with a Recon from Markham Technologies, the undisputed leader in underwater cameras.
Everything you'd expect from a premium quality fish house and so much more. Glacier combines superior craftsmanship and premium quality materials to produce a comfortable and enjoyable mobile base camp for your next outdoor adventure. Available in a variety of models, a Glacier Ice House offers more standard features, more usable space, and a better fit and finish than the competition. Visit our website at glacierisehouse.com to find a dealer near you and see why a Glacier fish house is the ultimate way to play.
At Aluma, we're in it for the long haul. That's why we make the longest lasting, most rugged trailers on the road. Flatbeds, bike haulers, tilt trailers, and enclosed. If you have a lot to move, we've got your way to move it. Our lightweight aluminum trailers will handle even your heaviest loads. At Aluma, we are right behind you with an industry-leading 5-year warranty. Because every trip and every load is valued.
Skeeter Boat Center is now a full-service Warrior Boats dealer, offering the complete line of Warrior Boats, all covered by reliable Yamaha outboards. With dealerships located in Ramsey, Minnesota and Chippewa Falls, Wisconsin, Skeeter Boat Center carries more Warrior Boat models in stock than any other Warrior Boat dealer. No matter which Warrior model is right for you, you'll receive the same attention to detail and service after the sale that made Skeeter Boat Center the number one Skeeter dealer by volume in the Midwest. For the best selection of fiberglass fishing boats and unmatched service, stop in or visit us online at SkeeterBoatCenter.com.
Oh,
there we go.
I'm going to keep fishing, see if we can't double up.
Yeah.
Talk a little bit about the technique that you're using to work that bait.
You don't want to be too aggressive. Let the bait do the work for you and just real subtle, you know, lift up. It's not a real just rip it up and get it to vibrate, you know, so much to where you're feeling it real hard in your rod.
And you think these guys are feeding on gobies, just kind of exploding up from under the rocks?
Yeah.
Off the bottom?
They're just up here chasing their next meal. Opportunity feeders. Yeah, let's keep you out on that little guy.
Boy, that's a chubby one.
Yeah, he's been down there feeding. Pliers here.
You know, I'm gonna bet that when it comes to eating stuff, there's probably not much that a lake trout won't eat.
Yeah, I would agree to that.
And that guy has not missed any meals.
Getting covered in slime today. Another little, nice little guy. Fun, nonetheless. Yeah. Didn't miss a beat.
So what depths are you targeting when you're out here chasing these lakers? I mean, you're not ever fishing real deep, are you?
No, you know, this time of year, you know, we're just, there's plenty of break walls down here in southern Indiana. And we're just, you know, fishing outside of them, 45 feet of water. It doesn't get too much deeper here in this part of the lake. It's a real big basin. But, you know, they're just chasing these fish up on the rocks, well, the gobies. And so we're imitating that and chasing them.
Fish! Oh my, does that one feel good? Good head shakes on this one. I think this one's gonna be my biggest fish yet. Oh yeah, a lot of power there. Yeah, just like lake trout everywhere, they fight hard. You can feel that big, powerful tail sweep. Just yeah, we're not even close yet. I haven't seen the leader. I got a long fluorocarbon leader on there, about 12 feet long. So we'll see the leader way before we see the fish. I got a medium heavy Helio spinning rod here. It's 7 foot, 1 inch. It's such a stout rod for a spinning rod. And I am leaning on her as much as I can, and I'm not sure I'm making all that much ground yet.
That's gonna be a pretty good fish here.
I think so. Oh, well, there's a leader.
The leader.
Should be seeing her soon here. Come on, big girl. Come on, big girl.
Yeah, nice fish.
Oh yeah.
That's a good fish.
Woo! I'll take it.
Absolutely.
Thank you. Oh,
got some weight to her.
I like it. Oh, what an old warhorse. These fish are so old and they get so much character. They wear their battle scars well. Hooked real light, right where a guy would want it. That fish wasn't going anywhere. All right. Look at that, people. That is a long lake trout. Big one. Oh. That's a lot of fight, let me tell you. You get that on a spinning rod, that's something else. All right, we're gonna let this one go. Get her back in the water quick. Woo! Oh, what an old warrior. He's ready to go. I was gonna cradle her and be all caring and all that, but she just wanted to go.
Don't have to do that at 33 degrees.
That feels good.
Yeah.
Feels like I've been working out in the gym. Right there is why we made the drive over here. That's why I'm so very glad that Chris invited us over here. Just not very often a guy gets to do this, particularly this time of year. I mean, January, back in Minnesota, we're staring down little holes in the ice. And I love doing that, but this is a treat.
In-depth outdoors, spot on the spot ID.
So in today's spot on the spot ID, I want to talk about the general type of structure, habitat these Lakers are looking for. I mean, of course, anybody familiar with fishing lake trout on Lake Michigan, you automatically think of trolling out in deeper water, but that's not where you're going to find these fish this time of year. So if you look at the map here, we focused in on the southern portion of Lake Michigan, but this is not an isolated bite. The season opens a little later in Milwaukee, but there's a very good lake trout bite in and around the Milwaukee Harbor, breakwalls and openings into the harbor. And that bite stretches all the way down the western shoreline, down past Chicago, into Indiana waters. And what you're looking for is harbor mouths, breakwalls, where deep water abuts those large, massive piles of rock. Those lake trout are using that rock to feed. Could it be gobies, alewife? I'm not sure what they're feeding on. But from the look of these fish, they're feeding very, very well. And they'll stay in these locations. Chris was very adamant that this bite is available all winter long until you get into the first serious warm-up of spring, whether it be April, late March. As soon as you get those 60 degree daytime temperatures and that water temperature starts to rise into the 40s, these fish are gone for the year. But until that happens, anytime you get a warm up, if you got access to the boat, this fishing, it's just sitting there waiting for you. And this type of bite, let me tell you, for me, there's really nothing better than to take a break midwinter, get the boat out, grab those long rods. It's all walleye gear, so it's a ton of fun. Hook up one of these big lake trout, and I guarantee you, you won't be thinking about ice fishing for a while.
Markham Technologies unleashes GPS with the release of the RT9, the first to combine sonar, underwater camera, and navionics mapping in a 9-inch ruggedized touchscreen tablet. Built on the Android operating system, the Wi-Fi-enabled RT9 can be used as a standalone tablet or snap into the cradle or performance pack for unmatched portability. Ice Electronics, the way they were meant to be. Sonar, GPS, underwater camera, one unit. Experience the RT9 from Markham Technologies. The lithium laser and lithium chipper from StrikeMaster deliver power on demand with the push of a button and an industry-leading 50-volt lithium ion battery. Reach for the lithium laser if you need unmatched hole-punching speed, or opt for the lithium chipper if you need the durability of chipper blades for opening old holes or drilling in dirty ice. No matter which auger is right for the way you fish, reach for a StrikeMaster Lithium, the electric auger with power to spare.
You know, we're not getting these fish every cast, so you kind of fall into a rhythm where you kind of check out mentally a little bit, and they wake you up in a hurry.
Yeah, they do, that's for sure.
These fish really haven't stopped biting today. I mean, we've had little flurries here and there, but it's been basically from start all the way through. That's nice.
That is.
Oh yeah, that's a good fish.
I can get them for you.
Double pinned right on the tip of her nose there. Thank you, sir.
You bet. Oh,
blades out, awesome. I love it. Oh, come here, fish.
He's sure been putting on the feed bag again.
Just think of how many gobies it takes to build one of these. Come here. Oh, man. The average size on these fish is awesome. So strong. They just never stop swimming. Even when you get them out of the water, you're holding on to them, they're just still swimming. Such a cool fish. I like this place. There we go. Oh. See you later, Trout. Down to the depths. That is too cool. So I'm pretty sure somebody watching this is gonna probably wanna come out and give this a try. We've talked about the gear we're using, and now we're gonna talk a little bit more about how to present these baits so you can come out here and catch a few fish yourself. We're fishing gold half-ounce blade baits. Old river standard, course, there's lots of lake applications too. We fish them a lot for walleyes in the spring. Biggest thing where people kind of make a mistake that costs them a lot of fish is they overwork these baits. I mean, when you really swing your rod tip hard and fast, you get this real intense vibration through the rod, and you might think that, well, that's something the fish are gonna like. And really the opposite is true. Even though it's a fairly unlifelike looking piece of metal, what you wanna do is just barely move it through the water column. Just get it to flutter just a little bit and then drop it back to the bottom. That's a lot more reasonable when it comes to getting a fish to eat it than that real hard lawnmower pull where it just zips through the water. Very rarely have I ever had a hit working a bait like that. Mostly it's just small pumps. You start to feel that blade bait vibrate in the water column, let it fall right back down to the bottom. Occasionally, if you're lucky, you'll get one at the top of the jig stroke. That's when you really feel that collision. Oh, good man. Ho, 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 ho.
I didn't even move that bait.
That looks like a net fish too. Oh yeah.
Yeah, feels pretty good.
You got the medium heavy or the medium?
I'm using a medium.
You're more sporting than I.
All right, back to the bottom.
Yes, that fish is gonna have none of it. This is not a bad way to spend a warm winter's day.
No, no, it sure breaks that cabin fever.
And you don't ice fish at all?
No, not around, you know, around here we get so many thaws and freezes. You know, we get a good winter steelhead run, so if I'm not out here, it's usually where you can find me.
We're starting to stack up the fish pretty good.
Yeah?
Hey, we're not fishing bluegills. I mean, you stick 6-8 of these in the morning, that's a good morning.
Yeah.
There he is.
There he is.
Oh, I got him.
All right.
That guy is almost orange.
Yeah. Oh. All right. Get that last hook out here. There we go. Beautiful fish. Can't complain.
No, not a
bit. Well, let's get him back in the water and get another one. What do you say?
I'm down.
All right.
So that brings us to the end of today's show. We had some phenomenal action out there catching lake trout on walleye gear. I look forward to getting a chance to do this again, and I want to send a huge thank you to Chris for sharing this bite with me. Chris, this summer, make sure you find your way to Minnesota mid-July. I'll put you on some great lakers out there on Lake Superior. So before we go, just want to let everybody know we will be back out on the ice next week. In fact, we're headed west, way west, to go fish with Andy Fiolka and see if we can't find some of those 2.5-3 pound perch that he's famous for. So thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you next week.
For more info on the latest fish reports, gear recommendations, and hottest techniques, connect with us online at indepthoutdoors.com or follow us on Facebook at In Depth Outdoors. And if you enjoyed today's show, be sure to let our sponsors know.